They can emerge in their version of the coming year's budget. This year, they proposed to take the governor's suggestion to cut $9.5 million from people with developmental disabilities. And then they added an additional $14.5 million in cuts. So the total cut recommended by the House Finance Committee equals $24 million for the coming fiscal year. Overall, this committee recommended a $160 million cut in state spending, of which people with developmental disabilities will bear 15.2%. And if you consider the cuts that have occurred since 2009, just 3 short years ago, people with developmental disabilities have lost over $37 million for services and supports that keep them safe, healthy, and productive members of our Rhode Island community. One piece of information I want to share with you. As I was preparing to come here today, I received an email of an article printed in the New Republic by a gentleman named Harold Pollack. In a review of the newly released State of the States in Developmental Disabilities, which is essentially an industry bible on national trends in DD services and spending, his analysis indicates that, quote, across the nation, the average spending reduction was 12%, with Alabama, South Carolina, Idaho, and Rhode Island reducing expenditures by more than 25%. He also notes that the nation proved, he also notes that the last edition of this report proved a sobering window into the human impact of the current recession. IDDD services serve a highly valued, highly vulnerable population. States' different approaches to preserving or cutting these services in hard fiscal times provides a real signal of states' larger values and vision of government. With that, I'd like to introduce to you the people that you're here to hear. I'd like to first introduce Cindy Pan. She is the mother of a 26-year-old son and is here to talk to you about her experience. My name is Cindy Pan. Saw fit to take 24 change pledge. I hope that people will call everybody they know, and I pray that God himself intervenes. Thank you. Thank you, Cindy.
I was about to go up and help, but,
Yeah.
up the funding needed to support all individuals with developmental disabilities now. If my son loses his supports, the impacts I've had on my family will be significant and life-altering. I would like to make the following points. The individual impacts on my son will be that he not only loses his supports, but he will also suffer loss of self-esteem and his identity as a member of this community. He will also lose wages and the friendships he has made through his work. He will also be at risk for increased behavioral issues because his day will change and he will be left to be more at home. I also would like to point out, more importantly, that he will be at risk of being institutionalized.
Yes.
I believe the state has promised to not institutionalize our people. In time, families will